Joining us now from the press studio is Allan Kelly from Riversgold. And Allan, today we're going to do a bit of an update on your Western Australian assets because you've had some terrific maiden drilling results out from Queen Lapage, which is part of your large Kurnalpi project over there. What can you tell us about these maiden drilling results?
Yeah, we've just announced some results from the first aircore program at Queen Lapage. And this is a very large target. It's about 17 kilometres long, and 11 kilometres of that is under a salt lake called Lake Yindalgooda, and it's never had any exploration for almost 20 years. And what attracted us to the project was a couple of big major structures that run through the area under the salt lake, and there was some historic drilling on some of the islands within the lake that had some pretty interesting numbers. So we went out and did a aircore program using a special lake drilling rig with very wide tracks that enables it to move on the surface of the rig of the of the lake, and we put out, we've got about 50% of those results back so far, and what they've shown us is a couple of very large gold anomalies, both over 2 to 2.5 kilometres long, and if you sort of join them up end to end, we've got sort of mineralisation over about 10 kilometres, and at that scale, at sort of 800 by 200 metre drill spacing, anything over about sort of 50 to 100 ppb gold is pretty interesting, but we're getting numbers up to, I think the best result was 13 metres at 0.6 of a gram, so that's 600 ppb, but that includes an intersection of 4 metres at 1.5 grams, so 1500 ppb. So those are very exciting numbers from a first drilling program of this nature. And I guess the thing that we want to get across to people is the size of this thing. This is, you know, this is 10 kilometres long, so with sort of very wide-spaced aircore drilling. So you could pick this up and drop this over the St Ives gold camp and it would be the same size. And St Ives is about, you know, 8 million ounces or so, with a number of 1 to 2 million ounce deposits within it. So that's what gets us very excited about this. We've still got about 50% of the results to come in. And hopefully we should get them in the next week or so. But it's definitely justified our excitement about this project, given the size, the scale, and the potential for multiple opportunities there under the lake.
Do you think that these discoveries are going to change your plan of attack for the Kurnalpi project overall? Of course, you have done a lot of work on the Far Jones prospect within that large tenement site.
Yeah, so what our strategy is we've got a very large position in what we call the Kurnalpi region, but our main focus is on a major structure that's called the Randall Fault, and that fault is over about 100 kilometres long. So we've got a sort of 15 to 17 kilometre long segment of it at Queen Lapage, and then we've got another position down at Venetian, just to the south, but then the other project that's taking up most of our sort of focus at the moment is Far Jones, and that sits on the southern end of the Randall Fault. And since we started drilling there in the middle of last year, we've made 4 new gold discoveries along that structure. We've got high-grade RC results at Far Jones itself, where we've got numbers up to 3 metres at 18 grams, including a metre at 48. And we recently announced in January the first aircore drilling along that structure to the north, and we've made 4 discoveries there, North Far Jones, at Eels, at Little, and then also we've looked at some historical drilling at a thing called Ella. And if you add all of those together, that's about 7 kilometres of mineralisation. That's again very widely spaced drilling so far. So we've got these 2 land positions along this Randall Fault, and we see those as, you know, giving us multiple opportunities for discoveries. And the great thing about Kurnalpi, it's fantastic access. We're only about 50 kilometres east of Kalgoorlie. We've got the Union Pacific train line and the trans access road runs right through the middle of our projects. And we've got a number of operating gold mines and processing plants within trucking distance if we find something, you know, that has size and grade to justify development. So we think we're in a fantastic area. The results we're getting so far are showing us that there's a lot more to be discovered in this area, and we think we're well on the way to a couple of discoveries.
Well, speaking of the neighbourhood, remind viewers about the various strategic development options that you have there and what sort of directions Riversgold is considering at this early stage.
Yeah, well, I guess there's a couple of things. Like I said, the location itself is fantastic. We've got really good access. Silver Lake have got their processing plant only about 7 kilometres from our Far Jones project. And their haul road runs east-west from the Coroni project right across the bottom of our projects over to their mill. There's also, you know, a couple of mills within trucking distance in Kalgoorlie. And then the other thing is that when we listed last in 2017, we had Evolution Mining, you know, Australia's second largest gold producer, come in with a strategic cornerstone investment in the company as well. So, you know, they're looking at an investment in us and hoping that we find something that they might want to come along and be part of in the future as well. So we've got a couple of options there for, you know, developing a project should we find one. And just the location itself gives us lots of options as well.
Allan, we know that Riversgold holds a portfolio of assets spanning Western Australia as well as South Australia and Alaska. But would you say these West Australian projects form your flagship at this stage? What sort of proportion of money and efforts going here?
Yeah, I guess they're two different parts of the strategy of the company. We've got the company maker sort of elements in Alaska and South Australia, you know, looking for the elephants in elephant country, so to speak. But both of those areas are, I guess, more high risk would be fair, but the prize is much bigger. You know, in Alaska, you're looking for multi-million ounce deposits like Pogo or Donlin Creek and things like that. But in Alaska, you only have a short field season to work in. South Australia is similar. You're looking for very large iron oxide copper gold deposits like Olympic Dam or Prominent Hill or Carrapateena. But, you know, you've got thick cover and it's also quite sort of difficult to drill there as well. The other part of the strategy of the company is the stuff in WA. You know, you've got a very good land position. You've got infrastructure. The prize is potentially smaller, but is much easier to monetize easier to explore and easier to monetize if you do find something. So that's how we balance those sort of two project portfolios. And definitely the flagships at the moment are these two projects along the Randall Fault, because we think there's opportunity to find something quickly, drill it out, and then potentially work out what we're going to do with it, either develop it ourselves or do a deal with someone. And then if we can monetize that quickly, that means we can get on with other projects as well.
You've already told us that the second half of assays from RC drilling at Queen Lapage will be out shortly. What other key news flows do your shareholders have to look forward to in the short to medium term?
Yeah, so the second half, the aircore program is due shortly, hopefully in the next week or so. We've also got some samples in the lab from Far Jones that we're waiting on as well. And we've already planned our second drilling programs at Far Jones to follow up the aircore results. And I'm also in the process of planning the next round of drilling at Queen Lapage, pending the receipt of those other assays. So over the next, you know, 3 months, there's going to be, you know, quite a bit more drilling to go and lots of results. And hopefully people start to see, you know, the size and scale of these opportunities that we've got in Western Australia.
Allan Kelly, thank you.
Thanks very much.